is lactate testing necessary to improve your endurance performance? I'm going to try and answer that question, whether you're a cyclist, a runner, or maybe a CrossFitter who wants to improve his endurance, because we hear about lactate testing a lot nowadays, but is it actually necessary? Do you actually need it to perform? Before I answer that, let's dig into lactate a little bit and remind ourselves of what it is. So lactate is not the cause of fatigue, first and foremost. Lactate is actually half a sugar. So if you take a sugar molecule, C6H12O6, and you break it in half, give or take a couple atoms, you have a molecule of lactate. So lactate is literally just a byproduct of glycolysis. So the fact that your body uses sugars as a fuel, which let's remember happens at all intensities, right? It's wrong to say that you only use fat at low intensity and then you use sugar at high intensity. It's an oversimplification. What is true is that you use the most fats at low intensity, but you're still using sugars, right? If I were to prick my finger right now, I wouldn't have 0.0 millimoles of lactate. I would still have, you know, 0.5, maybe 1, maybe 1.5, depending on when I ate last, depending on my metabolism in general. We'll typically see people between 0.5 and 1.5 at rest. That's kind of the normal range that I'm used to seeing. And so your body is always using lactate to some extent as a fuel, right? It's not the cause of fatigue. We thought lactate was the cause of fatigue for a long time, simply because when they were doing persistence hunting, they would find lactate in the blood of the stags that they were hunting. So they thought, hey, there's lactate, they're fatigued, and so lactate must cause fatigue. And to this day, a lot of people think that lactate, or lactic acid, as some people call it, is the cause of fatigue, but it is not. It is just a byproduct of glycolysis. What is true, however, what we can say, is that lactate is a good surrogate marker or a good proxy for fatigue, meaning that as lactate accumulates in the blood, we are also going to see an increase in other metabolites, namely inorganic phosphate, that are the main cause of peripheral fatigue inside the muscle, and hydrogen ions, H+, which seem to be responsible for the fatigue on the central nervous system standpoint, so the central aspect of fatigue. And those correlate quite closely with the accumulation of lactate. So when we see lactate in the blood, we can say those other ones are going to be high as well, and those are going to be causing fatigue. So even though lactate doesn't directly cause fatigue, it is associated with other molecules that themselves cause fatigue. So that's the first thing to understand. Lactate is a fuel. Lactate is being used by your body constantly to recycle ATP. It's being used, namely, in your mitochondria. This is where it can be transformed. It is used by your liver, it is used by your brain, it is used by your heart. So your body absolutely needs lactate. And why is then lactate used in training or for training purposes? What you can do is measure the lactate that's in your blood, and with this, figure out the internal load, the metabolic load that corresponds to the external load that you're pushing. So we could talk about watts on a bike, we could talk about minutes per kilometer, kilometers per hour in running. So that is a measure of external load. And internal load has two main branches: the perceptive branch, so what you feel, which is RPE, which I've talked about in other videos, and the metabolic side, where you're going to be able to measure heart rate, lactate, muscle oximetry, VO2, and those kind of things. And the main difference between, say, heart rate and lactate, because you might ask yourself, yeah, but I don't need to measure lactate if I can measure heart rate. Those are two different things. Heart rate gives you a very global view of the strain that is put on the heart by the exercise, but it is not going to help you to the same extent as lactate can, especially not when it comes to figuring out what we call thresholds. So where the body switches It's not a level, it's trying to always kind of reimagine ways of explaining it. It's kind of levels in the way your body operates with effort. And I would say there's three levels, right? There's low intensity, medium intensity, and high intensity. Medium intensity is when your muscle, the muscle that's producing the effort, can actually manage this effort by itself. And what I mean by that is, even though you are producing lactate in that process, you are also recycling lactate, and you're recycling more than you're producing. And this is why when we measure lactate at low intensity, zone one, zone two, we'll typically see lactate values that are equal or lower than the ones that we see at rest, right? Because your body is actually recycling more than it's producing. And this is what low intensity is. This is what happens below what we call the first threshold, first lactate threshold. And yeah, there's other ways of measuring lactate, but this is one of them. Measuring threshold, but this is one of them. At medium intensity, your muscle cannot manage everything that's produced. And again, lactate is not the cause of fatigue, but we can take it as a marker or a surrogate or a proxy for fatigue metabolism or fatigue metabolites. At medium intensity, your muscle cannot recycle everything that's being produced anymore. And so what we start to see is elevated lactate levels in the blood. Elevated, but stable. Obviously, if you push that for a very long time, they're going to elevate more and more and more. But in the first place, you are going to see elevated lactate levels in the blood after a few minutes of effort, simply because your muscle cannot manage everything internally anymore, and so you have that kind of extra lactate that is pushed into the bloodstream so that it can be recycled elsewhere. And then you have the third level beyond the second threshold, which we call high intensity, and this is where your body can no longer stabilize its internal processes, and it's kind of a runaway effect. And we are going to push towards high levels of lactate, high heart rate, VO2 max, and you're going to have to slow down or stop pretty soon because you cannot sustain that type of effort. So lactate helps us parse out those different types of intensities. So it is useful, but going back to the original question of the video, you don't absolutely need it. You don't need it at the start. Now, it's useful because it gives you information so that you can target different types of training, so you could target different types of intensities, but you can, to some extent, work without it. Now, when you start being very structured in your training, I would highly recommend you add lactate into the mix or lactate measurement so that you can test yourself, so that you can monitor, because beyond just testing, doing a lactate test is cool. But actually monitoring sessions while you're doing them is, I think, somewhere where we can gain even more understanding of how our body works, and also measure progress over time. Because a structured test has the disadvantage of being about how you feel that day, how your body operates that day. We know there can be variation in lactate from one day to the next, obviously, heart rate as well, VO2 as well. But when you monitor frequently the training sessions that you're doing, for example, monitoring a zone two session, monitoring a zone three or zone four sessions, and that's where it's going to be the most useful, I would say, in training, is looking at how your body reacts when it's in a steady state, whether it's the local steady state at low intensity or is it the systemic steady state at high intensity, or medium intensity. This is where you get the most value from monitoring a session with lactate. But like everything, as my good friend Kierwin and Flat says, when you use advanced methods with an athlete that doesn't actually need them, you rob them twice. You rob them of the basic linear progress they could get without those advanced methods, and you rob them of the potential gains they could have had down the line with those advanced methods. So I would say that lactate is the same. When you're beginning, when you're starting out, you just need to train, you just need to do the work. And I think you can go a very long way with just power / speed and RPE. And maybe start looking at your heart rate. But again, I wouldn't get too hung up on it. I would mainly operate based on external load and perceptive internal load, so the output, and then the costs internally that that represents from a perception feeling standpoint. And you can go very, very far just with those. And if you're interested in learning more about RPE, I have a mini course on the matter. If you sign up for my free cardio course in the description, after video 4, you'll get an opportunity to jump on the bandwagon. There's even a little cardio program to help you learn about training zones and learning to apply RPE in training. So if you're interested in that, that might be interesting for you. I would start with that. And I think you can go a year, 2 years, 3 years without even worrying about measuring lactate. Because again, you can gain a lot of insight on yourself and you can train. You just need to put in the hours and you just need to be consistent. That's where it starts, right? If you want to over-optimize everything from the start, I think that's a great way to run out of improvement potential and also just burn out from trying to focus on too many things at once. How about you just train? How about you just enjoy the process? And then when you start getting to a significant volume of training, when you start seeing some pretty good numbers, then we start worrying about lactate. Then we start worrying about testing. Then we start worrying about monitoring. Now, it doesn't mean you can't do a lactate test to gain insight and information on how your body works, or maybe track your progress over time, but you don't absolutely need it to start. That's the, I think, the takeaway of this video. You can go a long way without those things and only use those more advanced methods when you actually get to need them, right? When what you're currently doing doesn't suffice and you want to go a step further and you want to get to the next frontier and break through a plateau that you're currently at, now is the right time to add something. But otherwise, stick with what you're doing, be consistent, have fun, listen to your body, watch videos, listen to podcasts, learn, apply, test, see what works. This is the process of training, and this is how we move forward. If you have any questions about lactate, about testing, about physiology, about endurance, or anything else, leave them in the comment. I'm excited to do more videos again on the channel. So if you're enjoying them, please let me know. And yeah, feel free to submit some topics that I can cover. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care.